Back on the Shtick with Rabbi Yaakov Glasman. Hi, Yaakov.
Thanks for having me again.
That's all right, you're back.
Yes.
And we're just talking about interfaith relations, and in regard to religion, there is an issue at the moment which I think is on everybody's lips, and that's about marriage equality.
Yes.
And I had a lady from the Progressive Synagogue, or the Temple we should call it, Kim Ettlinger, and I just wanted to know what the Orthodox view was in a nutshell.
I think it's pretty predictable. Look, obviously, I would not support a change in the current legislation. I think you'd be pretty hard-pressed to find any Orthodox rabbi who would, to be completely honest. Ultimately, we do live in a democratic society, and the issue is going to be decided through the parliament. And I have no doubt that if that legislation were to pass, I'm sure parliament would create the appropriate the appropriate protection for religious institutions and so on.
But all Orthodox, like whether you're Islamic or Christian or Jewish, if you're Orthodox and you don't believe in marriage equality, then you wouldn't be performing those ceremonies.
Well, I think it depends how you term it. You'd call it marriage equality. Others call it same-sex marriages. Yeah. It's all. Whatever. But I think far more fundamental to that question is the question of inclusion of gay members of the Jewish community within the Jewish community.
I think that's the real crux of the issue.
I believe that is where the Orthodox rabbinate has to sort of focus its energies, which is the notion of, you can have your view on same-sex marriage, but that should never, ever, ever translate into any form of prejudice,
exclusion,
or bigotry, or anything like that.
Because that's the word, exclusion.
Well, that's the thing.
Because people feel excluded, they don't come, and you've lost people who may be wanting to be there.
That's right.
Who don't want to be progressive, but have always belonged to the Orthodox.
That's right. And I think that an element of respect, human dignity, is really should be at the centre of our focus on that, irrespective of one's views on same-sex marriage per se.
Very interesting.
Yeah.
And you're also a white ribbon ambassador.
Yes, I should be wearing the white ribbon.
Where is your white ribbon? You've got a white shirt on, that's all right.
So I'm coming from another place and I wasn't able to get back from my office, but anyway.
That's okay, it's your day off today.
Yeah, it is, thank you.
And so that's about family violence, isn't it?
Yes, look, I've been involved in that area for some time, and predominantly whilst I was heading the rabbinical council, we had a very strong working relationship with the Jewish Task Force Against Family Violence, which is, of course, very
focused
on that. Yes, Debbie Wiener and so on. In fact, one of our prominent members of the St. Kilda Hebrew congregation was just recently appointed to a position in the Jewish Task Force. There was actually a very unfortunate episode that I experienced, which very much prompted my interest in the area of family violence. I was at a seminar delivering a talk, and after the talk, a young woman who had recently been divorced had come up to me to ask me a question. And as we were talking face to face, I developed an itch under my yarmulke. So I lifted up my hand just to scratch it, and she immediately cowered down like this. And I thought to myself, I was just frozen. And it dawned on me after we started speaking a little bit more that she had been in a very abusive relationship.
And she was traumatized.
She was so traumatized that the mere notion of a male person standing in front of her lifting his hand up above his shoulder meant an inevitable beating. And to me, it was so paralyzing to watch that, that on an emotional level really triggered my interest in it. And I've sort of focused on it a lot during White Ribbon Day every single year. In my synagogue and elsewhere. So it's a critically important issue, family violence, and one that I think has to be really, really tackled at all levels, from government all the way down to community.
Yeah, we had Natasha Stott Despoir on the show last year, and she was very
incredibly active in that area.
In that area. The other thing we want to talk about is your YouTube message every week.
Yes, well, look, we are blessed with a very large congregation. The honest truth is that most of them don't come to shul on a regular Shabbat. They know it, and there's no judgments over there. But I figure, why not make a weekly sermonette available online for people who, for whatever reason, aren't going to come to shul? At least they'll get something from the parsha. Yep. So I tend to take a theme from the Torah portion and something that's topical or current affairs, marry the two together in a short 2 to 3 minute clip, and I produce a YouTube clip every week, and people tell me that they enjoy it very much. So
fantastic. So anyone who wants to watch Yaakov on YouTube,
subscribe
there's
to the St Kilda Shul newsletter, and it's a free subscription. Yeah,
fantastic. And you also take Tanya classes, which is a Kabbalah event.
Yes,
every week.
So it was actually by request of members of the congregation that we embark on a journey of spiritual study, not just the legalistic Talmudic halachic stuff. And the Tanya is one of the more seminal books, one that I've studied many times. And it's a very, very, it's not an easy read. It's not sort of bedside reading, but a very profound insight into the Jewish soul, how what makes it tick. What our relationship with God is, what it ought to be, how we're able to foster it. And we've been giving those weekly classes for the last 2+ years, and it's been consistent,
the attendance.
It's fantastic.
It's on a Monday night.
Monday nights, every Monday night, yeah.
Fantastic. And one last thing I wanted to talk about was a concert that you had at Shul a couple of weeks ago, and the Maccabees were the big attraction.
Yes, well, the Maccabees are huge. I mean, they performed everywhere, including in front of the United States president. The shul is a very much a musical shul, St Kilda. It's always been a very choral congregation, so we love music. We brought the Maccabees down, I think it was 3 years ago, had it at the Robert Blackwood Hall in Monash University.
Which I filmed, yeah.
Oh, which was great, and it was a brilliant. I hope they gave you a free ticket. I'm sure they would have.
I always get free tickets.
And this time, we heard they were coming back to Australia. We said, look, come visit Melbourne for a once-off performance.
Yeah.
But this time, why would we take the audience to Monash University if we can try and do it in our own shul? Mm. You know, so we said, let's work out all of the audio and the visual and all of that. And we tried to create that environment, and it was packed. It was a fantastic experience. And, you know, the kids loved it. The parents loved it. The grandparents loved it. They are a highly engaging a cappella group.
Mm.
And they've had a lot of success in recent years. You know, I think over 20 million YouTube hits since they started. I wish my YouTube clips got half of that.
Yeah, I wish ours did too. So we're actually going to be seeing the Maccabees at the opening of the next segment. And the night that they were performing at St Kilda Shul, Helen Kapelos gave a talk at Beth Wiseman, which I was already engaged and had committed myself to, so I couldn't come. But we're going to see a bit of the Maccabees at the beginning and end of the next segment. And we'll be having Helen Kapelos in the studio in the next segment, talking about a life of its own, her research into medical marijuana in Israel. So that's going to be very interesting. Just a little short one. Yaakov Glasman.
Thank you so much for having me. Appreciate it.
You're a lovely man. Everyone keeps telling me.
Well, I pay him well to say that.
Thank you. Thanks. We'll see you after the break.